Jason, why does he look like that?
He's just a logger. Nothing to worry about, Michelle.
Why is he not moving? That guy gave me a really bad feeling.
You have nothing to worry about. He's just a logger. And even if you did have something to worry about, we're in a car, so don't stress about it.
Okay.
Just relax, babe.
I have to go so badly.
Can you just hold it for 10 more minutes? We're almost home.
No, I've been holding it for the past hour.
For real?
Just please stop.
Okay, fine. Just make it quick before the homeowners see you.
And watch out for poison ivy.
Jason? Is that you?
This is an emergency broadcast. A 230-pound, 5'11 crazy guy has just escaped Winchester Prison. This is a very dangerous and violent individual. If you see him, please contact authorities right away and lock your doors and hide. I repeat, lock your doors and hide.
Okay, Jason, this is not funny anymore.
Michelle?
Babe, where are you?
Michelle! Michelle!
Michelle, babe! What happened to you?
No. No. Michelle, stay with me. Stay with me.
Oh.
Come on.
Michelle.
Like a ship on the ocean, a jack of all into fortune. Dad, I don't know if you could hear me right now or if I'm just talking to myself, but remember that time when my babysitter Roger threw me down the stairs in a laundry basket? He sliced my head open on the bricks at the bottom of the steps, and when you came home, you slapped him so hard across the face you made a grown man run home crying. You ran out the door and you said, if you even come in within a mile of my son again, next time my fist is gonna be closed. This is what I'm gonna do for you, Dad. I'm gonna beat down that murderer to hell.
Michael? Come here, please. How would you like to earn some money?
Mom, I don't want to clean your hospital bathrooms again.
It was a good experience for you. Keeps you from making those films about death and stuff.
It's art.
It's weird and strange. Anyway, you know your Uncle Bobby?
What about him?
Well, Aunt Jenny and the kids are going to Grandma's place up in Canada for the entire month. And Bobby has to go away on a business trip, apparently.
I didn't know that Bob worked. Dad always said that he...
Well, your dad was wrong. Last I heard, he actually had some kind of cubicle job. Anyway, he asked if you would like to house sit for the next week or two.
His house is so far away. Are you
Michael,
sure?
Michael, it may do you good to get out of the city. Your sister could come too.
Aren't you coming?
No, I'm staying here. I still have a job to do. Plus, I could use a little alone time.
Okay, when am I supposed to go up?
He wants you up by tonight.
Tonight?
Yeah, tonight. Michael?
Do you knock?
Hazel, get packing.
Wait, what? Why?
We're going to Uncle Bob's place to house sit for him for a while.
Is Mom coming?
No. Crystal? Yeah. We're coming over to pick you guys up in about 30 minutes. Pack for 2 weeks. Yeah, he can come. Paisley! Hurry up!
Ready!
Where exactly is the address of the house again?
Oh, it's right here. 49 Salem Street.
Oh. Thanks.
Give me hugs! Goodbye. Be safe. Call me when you get there.
We will.
Bye, Mom. Love you.
Hey, Michael, pop the trunk for us.
Hey, Paisley. I didn't know you were coming.
Yeah, Crystal's babysitting me.
This is going to be so much fun.
Hit the road, guys.
I brought my funky beats for the 5-hour car ride.
Hit it!
Yeah.
This would be good for some nature photography.
Have you found any new information about...
about your dad's murder? No. We're kind of at a dead end now. I'm sorry. You know, I was thinking we could film a movie with this or something. I was thinking like maybe like a chair chasing a few kids or something like that. I don't know. What do you think?
This is my song! Turn it up!
Good. I'll drive over when I'm done.
That's what I like to see. Keep it up, Paisley.
Upstairs. First come, first serve.
I know where I'm going! Ew! It smells like dead fish.
Hey kids. Thanks for house-sitting. I had a quick business meeting that came up. It shouldn't be longer than 2 weeks. The money's in the bedroom, where you normally stay in, Michael. Thanks again, kiddos. Uncle Bob.
Your uncle's really chill. He has good vibes.
Yeah. Sure.
This is Uncle Bobby, Aunt Jenny, their kids.
Paisley, Crystal already knows them already.
Oh.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend. We've known each other since we were 9 or 10. Together we've climbed hills and trees. Learned of love and
ABCs.
Skinned our hearts and skinned our knees. Goodbye, my friend, it's hard to die. When all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in the air. Pretty girls are everywhere. Think of me and I'll be there. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun. But the hills that we climbed were just seasons out of time.
A showbiz chicken. What she do, play the piano?
She plays the piano.
This is what we know so far. Your dad was killed last summer along with several other people. Sydney Smith was killed at her cabin at night. And Edward Johnson was camping at night in the woods when he was killed. And Tracy Lewis was at her night shift at Lucette's Pizza when she was killed. And then Greg Matthews was killed on the side of the road when he was sleeping in his car. And the most recent case was Jason Voren and Michelle Myers. They were found in the middle of the woods, but the police think that they were dropped there, that they were actually killed somewhere else. For all these cases, there were big rainstorms right before the murders, so there were no fingerprints or blood or anything like that at the scene of the crime. The police think that the killer lived in this town when he was killing, because all of a sudden it all kind of just stopped and the case
went cold.
Yeah.
How do we start?
Betty Myers. She lives on this lake. I was thinking we could go over there and ask her some questions about her daughter, Michelle. Maybe she can help us get some answers.
What's that gonna do?
Guys, what's happening?
This happens all the time. I just have to reset the breaker box underneath the house. Wanna come, Crystal?
Sure do.
It's really dark out here.
You're fine.
What if we see a bear?
We're not gonna see a bear.
I heard if it's brown, you lie down, and if it's black, you fight back, but what if it's not one of those two colors?
What other color would it be?
White!
In Minnesota?
Yeah. My whole family didn't believe that there were moose up here until I saw one. Who's to believe that there's not white bear up here, too?
What movie do you want to watch next? No, let it ring out. What do you think about Scooby?
Michael. Did you hear that? Michael.
Michael!
Michael, there was something in the woods.
Crystal, we're in northern Minnesota. Of course there's something in the woods.
Well, still.
Hey, Michael. What are these?
Just stuff, I guess.
Hey, Michael. I didn't know your uncle was a historian.
Yeah, me neither. You guys okay?
It was Dad speaking from the phone. He sounds scared. But then someone else spoke.
Are you sure it wasn't any other voice you recognized?
Why don't you believe me?
I know you heard a voice. It can't be Dad. He's dead.
But it was him.
Okay, fine. Fine, it was Dad. We live to see another sunrise.
What?
It's just that we're not guaranteed to see another one.
Oh. I was planning on going to Betty Meyer's place with Sandra and maybe Paisley. Do you want to come?
No. I was planning on going into town and do some looking there.
Good idea. I'll need as much information as fast so you can get it. I'm gonna go see if Sandra and Paisley are awake.
Xander, are you ready yet? Hey, Michael, toss me the keys. You know, you should really tell Paisley the real reason why we're here.
I know, it's just... I don't want to bring up any bad feelings, you know?
You can't heal bad feelings if you don't talk about them, Michael.
You know, it's just...
Ready!
Paisley? Are you up? It's 10, Paisley. You should get up.
I don't want to get up.
Why didn't you come to town with me? Like we used to with Dad.
Hi, I'm Crystal Mountain and this is Xander Lynn. We want to talk with you about something.
What for?
Your daughter, Michelle Myers.
So why do you want to know about my Michelle?
It's just that my friend's father was killed the same summer as your daughter. So
you're trying to find out who killed him. Don't even try. My husband and I tried, failed. Please try, fail, and you're gonna fail too.
Can you please just talk to us then?
Fine.
I guess we could start with what happened to her.
She was killed with her no good boyfriend. If it wasn't for him dying too, I would have thought it was him.
What was his name?
Jason Voren.
So if not him, then who?
Dan Mack. He never talked to anyone in town, and he liked to hunt squirrels in the park in front of children.
Why didn't anyone tell the sheriff?
He was the sheriff. But then when the murders happened, he packed up and went to Florida. But guess whose ass is back in town?
Why did he come back?
As if I know. I'll tell you what. Take down this number. 723-5576. That's Dan Mack's niece, Janet Ross. She knows more than I do. Here's my case files. When you're done, give them back to me. Now get out of here. I got better things to do.
Thank you.
It's just what? They don't tell me anything anymore?
You don't tell me anything either.
Like what?
Like where you always sneak off to at home.
That's none of your business.
You're going to college soon, so you won't have to fight or hide anything anymore.
Stop! We can't keep living like this.
Michael! Where are you going? Michael!
Remember this place, Paisley? Remember that big town we made out of sticks down here?
Yeah, we destroyed it by stomping on it. Do you remember when we used to throw pine cones on people on the trail, saying that I'd give them good luck?
We came down here and we would tell each other everything that happened that school year.
Why did our dad have to die the way that he did?
I don't know, Paisley. I don't think there'll ever be an answer to that question.
I want everything to go back to normal. I want to tell you everything. I want our family to be closer. I want Dad back.
Things will never go back to normal. That's just how it is. But we can't give up and go through the motions. We have to get through this. Together.
Why do you think you had to keep that from me?
Why I agreed to come down here was not to earn money, but to find out who killed Dad.
I want to help.
I didn't know if you wanted me to continue on with it. I know that Mom's moved on, and I thought you did too. But I don't think any of us can really move on until we find out who killed Dad.
Michael, back at home when I was sneaking out, I was sneaking to Dad's grave.
Who on earth does this? Kyle, this is not funny!
Oh my God, I'm gonna pee!
This is not funny.
Okay, come here. Let me help you.
You even have a napkin?
Hey, where are you going?
Ma'am? What's going on?
Remains of a dead body were found at the park.
Are we rolling?
Hi, I'm Stacy Hawkins. Female remains have been found at this park here. Our police force is concerned that the murders from last summer have started up again.
Yes, I did. But it's also kind of good news, because now he'll be easier to find. Paisley, can you grab me the butter? Oh, and Michael, there's a number over by the phone. It belongs to a woman named Janet. Can you call her and ask if we can meet up with her tomorrow?
Hello, this is Michael King. I am calling to talk to Janet Ross.
This is some kind of cruel joke.
No. I was given this number to call. I think we need a new phone.
You dropped us.
Do you know these people?
Hey! What are you guys doing? This is private property.
We bring no harm. We're just looking for the missing girl. My name's Heather and this is Christopher. We're search and rescue workers and we're looking for Nancy Thomas.
We were looking for a different woman, Janet Ross, but her remains were found earlier today, so you move on to the next one.
What?
But you have nothing to worry about, cutie.
Oh, brother.
That was Janet Ross? Sure was. Third missing person of the summer, yet first body found. By the Paul Bunyan statue?
As you have probably heard, there's another killer, a potential copycat of the one from last summer. So watch yourselves, okay? We're sorry for our entering on your property and we'll be out of your way. Stay safe.
What happened out there?
Crystal was hit by Cuban.
They seemed awfully suspicious, didn't they, Crystal?
Yeah, I guess. Suspicious and good looking.
They didn't even show us any identification badges.
Mac and cheese is ready!
No, we should probably go to bed early so we can get a good start to tomorrow.
Good idea.
We could go visit the island.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm gonna go to bed.
Good night.
Sandra, protect your innocence. Whatever's out there is going to find us with the burning embers, you dummy.
It should scare it away.
That's not how it works.
Yes, it is. Unless there's a person out there. But there's not.
This man was in the woods. He was chasing me. He had a bow and he was trying to shoot me.
It's going to be okay. You need to look at me. Honey, you need to look at me. Just look at me. Oh my God, it's Nancy Thomas. We will get you back to your family. Don't worry. What is it? What's going on? Look at me, will you?
Thank you.
is my walkie-talkie?
Let me go. I won't be afraid to shoot.
Hey, where are the keys?
What for?
I want to go to the crime scene to see if there's anything that they may have missed.
They're on the kitchen counter.
Cool, thanks. Sorry, didn't mean to do that.
Thank you.
This is an emergency broadcast to Elm County and all the surrounding counties.
A very dangerous man has escaped prison.
This man is...
If you're in Elm County or any other surrounding counties, you need to be very careful.
Watch your surroundings, lock your doors and your windows, and please avoid dark, isolated locations.
The city will be adding a curfew to 7 p.m. Do not stay later than that or your life is at risk.
If you see anything suspicious, please report it to the Elm County Police immediately.
Now back to your regular schedule.
Rise up and stand back, partner!
An egg beater?
Yeah, an egg beater!
Crystal, you okay?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Michael, are we in Elm County?
We are close, but...
But what?
But we are far enough away, so we shouldn't worry about it.
You sure?
Yes, I'm sure. Just don't worry about it. Enjoy the rest of the night.
Want to have a sleepover in your room?
I was going to ask you the same thing.
Are you not scared of the killer out there?
Well, at first I was, but Michael said that we'll be fine, and I trust him. Also, things like that just won't happen to us. It just doesn't happen.
I guess.
Paisley?
Yeah?
Can we start now?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Let's roll a dice to see who goes first.
Crystal, what happened at the Paul Bunyan statue tonight?
The killer,
You saw the killer? Could you tell who it was?
I couldn't. I really think we should get out of here, Michael.
But we've come so far. We can't stop now.
I could have been one of them.
And if we don't find out who it is, there are going to be plenty other people who would die because of him.
I don't want to be one of them.
Look, if tomorrow you want to leave with Paisley and Xander, fine. But I'm staying.
What's the point?
What's the point? My whole family's broken because of that guy. That monster took my whole family's life as well as my dad's. My mom pretends he never exists. Paisley will never have a dad to walk her down the aisle, and we've all lost her best friend. And so the only thing that will make this go somewhat back to normal is if that guy isn't roaming free. And I'm going to do everything in my power to make sure that happens.
Thank you.
Can't we just leave now?
No, it's too late for that. I already locked the door. Let's just go lie down and relax.
Ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready to go. Yeah.
Aren't you coming?
I want to stay.
Hazy, you're better off just getting out of here.
It's my dad too.
Okay, fine.
Paisley, are you coming?
I'm staying.
Okay, fine.
When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true.
The killer.
To think of something clever, to write myself a letter.
Why do we have to leave Paisley and Michael behind?
Because it's getting too dangerous for us to stay, Xander.
But friends don't leave friends behind, right?
Enough.
What's this?
It's a case files for Betty Myers. We have to return it to her before we leave. Stay here, Xander. This should only take a minute. Files you gave me. I won't be needing them anymore, so I'll just leave them. Hello? Mrs. Myers? I'll explain later.
Poor Betty.
I found these pieces of paper in her bathroom.
What does this mean?
I think we need to go back and help Michael and Paisley.
Crystal, Xander, what are you guys doing here?
The
killer's coming here later tonight.
And we came here to help.
So bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. And them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die. Did you write the book of love? And do you have faith in God above? If the Bible tells you so.
You need them up here.
Do you believe in rock and roll? Can music save your mortal soul? And can you teach me how to dance real slow?
And that should kill him. Hello?
Zero. Zero. One.
Hello, is anyone there?
0251.
Hello?
1 0 2 5 1 9 7 8 0 0 1 0 2 5.
What is it saying?
9.
I don't know, some sort of weird numbers.
Let me hear.
7 1.
It's saying a number.
Like a phone number?
9 7 8 0 0 1 0 2 5 9 7.
Try calling it.
Paisley, listen to me. I'm not gonna let anything bad happen to you. We're all gonna make out of this alive, okay? But you have to focus and stay calm.
Quickly, everyone go around the house to make sure everything is locked. If we stay down here, then he should not see us.
But he already knows we're here.
I know, it's just...
We can't do this alone. I'm so sorry, I thought that we could... That I could do this by myself, but... We need help. We need to call the police. Why is it not working?
It got fried the last time we used it. So now what?
Guys, I remember seeing a phone booth by the side of the highway. I'll go up there and call the police.
No, Crystal, you can die.
I'll be fine. I owe it to you guys anyways.
No, you don't.
See you on the other side.
911, what's your emergency?
I'm Crystal Mountain. I'm on 49 Salem Street, and there's this guy trying to kill us.
Okay, stay on the line. What does this guy look like?
I don't know. He was wearing some sort of a mask. He's gonna be here any minute now. Can you please hurry?
Okay, officers are on their way. Where are you now?
I'm in a phone booth along the highway.
Are there more people with you?
Yes, my friends Michael King and his sister Paisley, and my cousin Xander Lynn. Are they on their way?
Officers will be there in a bit. Just stay hidden.
How can I? I'm in a glass phone booth.
Hello? Are you still there? What's happening? Hello?
She'll be back soon.
Ah! Is he here?
No, he's not back. It's just a storm. We're gonna be fine.
But what if the killer cut the power so he can sneak up on us easier?
Paisley, shut up! That is not what's happening. There's a generator in their house. I'll go start that. Now you two go upstairs and lock your room and do not open the door for anyone unless you hear my voice, okay?
Okay.
Now go.
Bobby?
How long will it take for Mike to get the power back on?
I hope soon. Xander, the killer's outside. We have to hide.
Where?
Over there. What do we do?
I'll take the front door. Let's go.
This is the police.
Show yourself.
Help! I'm up here. Help, please help.
Don't worry. I'm coming up right now. Speak to me, kid.
I'm in the bathroom!
of here. Let's go. Let's get you out of here.
It's okay. We're gonna get you out of here just fine. I just found a girl in the upstairs bathroom.
Poor thing, scared out of her mind. Over.
Have you seen him anywhere inside?
No, I haven't, so be careful.
Copy that. You seen him, Officer Tom?
Nope, not in here. The light in their back garage just turned on. I'm gonna go check it out.
What was that, Tom? Tom, do you copy? We're not playing hide and seek anymore. Hey! Put your hands up. Make yourself visible. I said, make yourself visible. Thank you. Paisley! Paisley, where are you? Paisley!
Thank you. now. I don't understand.
Turn back now, Michael. It's not your time to go yet. Go.
Paisley, are you okay?
Michael, did we win?
No, Paisley. We didn't win. But we didn't lose either.
Xander! I saw him!
I know. He's with Dad now. Crystal is too.
Where's Dad?
He's with us, Paisley. He always has. He's been with you, Mom, me, this whole time. And Xander and Chris are with us too. Forever. His friends don't leave friends behind.
Promise?
I promise you, Paisley.
Thank you.
ago. I can still remember how that music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had my chance that I could make those people dance, and maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver, and with every paper I deliver, bad news on the doorstep. I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride, but something touched me deep inside the day.